These two characters are using the same animation, and I couldn't believe how broken one of them looked. I thought character retargeting Godot would be simple, but there were a few assumptions I got wrong. Let me show you what I learned while fixing it. What I mean by retargeting is sharing the same animation between similar, but different sized rigs. But why do I need this? Well, my game is going to have hundreds of different attacks, or arts, and it will be possible for characters to learn each other's arts too. And I would rather eat paint than retarget the animation separately for each character in Blender. So how did I approach this problem then? My naive self thought that just using a similar rig for both my current characters would be enough for animations to work, but boy was I wrong. It turns out that the animation's location data is based on the source rig's bone lengths. Therefore, when applying that to the second character, it tries to use the exact values from the base animation and yields this strange result. Oh well, there must be another way, right? Turns out there was, and it was staring me right in the face in Godot. So, bone maps are Godot's solutions to mapping your character's bones to a standardized bone set. This comes with two main advantages. One is that you could technically take two very different rigs and share animations between them, but the other advantage is what I'm looking for, the ability to normalize animations to the particular rig that's playing them. At first, I avoided this feature like watching paint dry because I didn't think I needed it. Both my characters use the same rigified meta rig, minus the added jiggle bones, but as we saw already, it didn't work. So now it was time to try this feature out. But let me show you my character rigs in Blender first so you can see how they are constructed. I won't show you how to make the rigs I have. I have a few tutorials for that already on my channel, but what I will show you is what bones and tech I used. Here is Kyla. She's the first character I modeled and rigged in Blender. I used Rigify, which means that first I have to generate this meta rig, and then generate the main rig from that. The way Rigify works under the hood is that when it generates the main control rig, it'll take the meta rig bones and copy them with def prefixed in their names. These are hidden by default, but you can show them by clicking the star in the outliner here. So the bones that really matter for this animation are the core set, which pretty much every humanoid character would have. Here's the spine, which Rigify calls spine 0 to spine 6, instead of the standard hips, chest, neck, head you'll see on an Unreal Mannequin or Mixamo rig. That means when I map the rig in Godot, I have to keep in mind the head is spine 6, the neck is spine 5, and so on. Now here's Xena's rig. It's pretty much the same except that she is a few inches shorter and not nearly as stacked. But you can see why I thought this would work before, given how similar the rigs are. You may have also noticed that there are a lot of extra bones on both rigs. Those bones are for adding jiggle physics within Godot itself, and they do not need to be keyframed. So what's nice is that when the retargeting happens, it'll focus on the core set of bones, and the jiggle bones are left alone to be simulated. With the rig set up similarly enough, let's go back to Godot to try out this bone map feature. I wish I knew this sooner because this part's way easier than I thought it would be. When I opened up my character's advanced import settings, I clicked on the Skeleton 3D node and it brought up the retarget option in the right side. Here I had to create a new bone map, which I used the Skeleton Profile Humanoid preset for. Turns out, it auto-mapped pretty much everything once I selected it. I thought I was going to have to do this myself. So with the bones mapped, that's it, right? Well, no. I have to tweak the settings below to get it to work. When I was figuring this out, I remembered finding a page on Godot's documentation about this feature, and it mentioned this exact issue. Which is good, because now I have some ideas on what to do, thanks to the documentation. I gotta say, I'm rarely let down by Godot's documentation, and this was no exception. I won't go into what every setting does, as the documentation is linked in the description, but I can highlight the two main settings that worked for me. Primarily, the normalized position tracks and the retarget method. The normalized position tracks setting helped with keeping the animation scaled properly based on the rig. This effectively prevents the model from looking like it's slipping. The other setting, retarget method, gives you a couple of options. Originally, I didn't want to use the retarget modifier as it was an extra node and it would add some overhead, but overwrite axis didn't quite work well on my characters, so I ultimately settled on the retarget modifier. It's not perfect, but it does make the retargeting process a heck of a lot easier. The retarget modifier works like this. It'll create the general skeleton, which has the retargeted core bones, such as the hips, arms, and legs. Then any other bones that aren't part of that set are preserved under the original skeleton, so things such as jiggle physics can still work. Given this, let's apply these settings on the other characters as well as the animations. I have to set this up on everything because otherwise Godot won't be able to match the rigs and the animations together. But it's not too hard to do, I just have to remember to apply the same settings each time I import a character or animation. So I went ahead and applied the exact same settings to Xena's GLTF settings and to each of the animation libraries. To test this, I opened up both character scenes and I added the basic locomotion animations to the animation library, and it ended up working well. Kyla looks normal, as expected, since I animated using her rig, but Xena is no longer floating and looks to be rocking the same animations. Talk about a relief. I thought I may have to do some voodoo with the Blender rigs to solve this problem, but it looks like there was indeed a system for this in Godot. Just took some research and a little luck. While I said this works well, there are a few things to be desired with this solution. First, there's some strange thing going on with the index finger. Looking into this, it seems that Godot's humanoid map has a slightly different bone table than Rigify uses, so it creates this finger issue. I should be able to solve this with the rig itself, but Rigify may not be too flexible with it. I may open a GitHub issue on the Godot repo if it comes down to it. Also, a while back in my shape keys video, I mentioned that keyframed shape keys from Blender will import properly into Godot. However, using a retarget modifier, that goes out the window. That's because it tries to locate the model in the hierarchy in the keyframes, but it's not correct due to the separate skeletons being there. This one I'll definitely need to open a GitHub issue on because I'd love to be able to animate expressions for special attacks down the line. And of course, the inherent issue of using extra nodes to perform retargeting. Generally speaking, I would imagine this has some performance implications, but as far as I can tell, it's working fine as of now. I'll keep an eye on it though. So that's it. That's all I have to share on the animation retargeting. Thank you all for those who watched through the end. It means a lot that internet strangers would potentially become fans of my work. If you're itching to learn more Godot stuff, like how the jiggle bones come to play, I have this video here on jiggle physics. Or if you want to check out how I made a Daydreamit animation system, check out my last video here. Otherwise, I hope you have a great rest of your day.